Back to my book review. So today I'm going to do a book review on the series The Kane Chronicles, the first book called The Red Pyramid. It's right here. And it seems this is covering one letter and half of the Y, supposed to say the Red Pyramid. So this book is by Rick Riordan, and he's a famous author. Most of you who watch might know him, and he makes mythology books, and you might have guessed, this is also a mythology book, and it's about the Egyptian mythology, and it's a fantasy genre. Yeah. So this book is about two children, Carter and Sadie, who think they're normal kids and live a normal life, and their dad, Julius Kane, is an Egyptologist who studies Egyptian mythology, and he travels constantly around the world. After his wife dies, he splits the two children between him and his wife's parents. So now Carter has to constantly travel with his dad, Julius Kane, and Carter has to travel with his dad and constantly go around the world, and Sadie has to live with her mother's grandparents. So Julius and Sadie, including Carter, can only meet twice or 2 days a year. So just like any other day, they meet again, and though this time their dad takes them to the British Museum, and on the way they say he's going to make things right, and they're just like mystified by that thought. When they're there, he goes to the Rosetta Stone, and he's with special permission, of course. He opens the glass casing, and when nobody's around, only his kids, he just starts mumbling and indistinct mumbling, and the Rosetta Stone explodes, and instantly their dad is banished in a golden coffin. Even though the kids don't know it, their father has unleashed 5 gods from Egyptian mythology, and 2 of them, Horus and Isis, have taken hosts inside Carter and Sadie. Now, with the 2 gods to guide them on their journey, Carter and Sadie embark on a dangerous journey to save their dads and possibly also save the world from the Chaos God, Set, one of the 5 gods released. And that's the god who encased their father. Yeah. So I really, really like this book because it has everything I want, like humor, adventure, suspense, plenty other things. I'm not gonna mention this for no reason. So I also liked it because the author does a good job in writing the book, make it even more interesting. He puts cliffhangers in like most of the chapters, and so you just want to keep reading. And yeah, I really like that because that's the reason I really like books, because authors make them kind of mysterious and you just want to keep reading. So, and last of all, I like it because it has mythology, and Rick Riordan makes mythology fun, in my perspective. So like, I just want to read Rick Riordan books because they're fun. And if you want to find out why they're fun for you, you might be motivated to read this. Well, thanks for listening to my book review.